rifles, generally speaking, are something you see on nothing but Instagram models, and I have to tell you that this Q Sugar Weasel is a fantastic option for a hard use rifle, and on top of all that, I think it could be a fantastic competition rifle. The Q Sugar Weasel is very well made. It looks freaking fantastic. It looks awesome. It's just a really cool overall profile for a rifle. On top on the front here, you have the MF and cherry bomb up there. We actually bought a whistle tip thread protector on there, which actually is more like a blast deflector, and that helps keep that blast from coming back and getting a lot of concussive force. The barrel from Q on here is a 5.56 mid-length gas system with an adjustable gas block. The adjustable gas block looks very well made and very well machined. Q is known for the machining and the looks of their rifles, and this one here is no exception. And with that being said, a lot of times people are under this conception that Q stuff's really expensive, and it is. The Q Fix, the Honey Badger, they're expensive rifles. The Sugar Weasel, I think Andrew picked this thing up for about $1,400, and for the features that come on it, I think it's a better rifle than most of the rifles in that price category, if not all of them. And on top of that, there's rifles that cost $900 more than this, maybe $1,000 more than this, that I've shot that don't shoot better than this thing. And with all that being said, most favorite part of this rifle, I know is interchangeable on rifles, but this comes with it, is their trigger. They dub it as literally the best trigger ever made. That is the name for the trigger itself, and holy smokes, this sucker is quite literally the best trigger I've ever felt on an AR. It is good. There's your tick up and the wall. So you got about like a, I don't know, we'll call it like a quarter inch of take up that's at like 2 pounds, and then about a 2.5 pound pull. Very consistent, very crisp, very clean. It is definitely better than any Geissele trigger I've ever shot, and they make fantastic triggers. This is just better. It's really a better trigger than those. And you're getting a rifle at this price point with an absolutely fantastic trigger that there's no way anybody could get this gun and need to change out the trigger unless you want something that's heavy. It's good. It's a very good, safe trigger. They designed it to be a drop safe trigger as well, which is good to see because there are competition triggers on the market that go down to like the 1 pound range and all that stuff that aren't drop safe. It's still a drop safe trigger on here. Back here, they have Radian safety selectors. With the Radian safety selectors, they're a short 70 degree throw, and they're also shortened on both sides. I don't notice flipping that safety selector that it's actually hitting my index finger. I do get that on some of the elongated selector switches. This one, however, I don't have that. It does have a Radian charging handle back here. The Radian charging handle also has like a reduced size wings on it versus the larger size, and it's a good size. I don't see any issues. I don't feel like it needs to be bigger. Coming in on the rifle, I'm not hitting my hands against the receiver whatsoever. You'll see with the receiver set on here, it is a clear anodized finish. It looks awesome. There is no forward assist on here. Now, for a duty rifle, I think it's a necessity. For a rifle that's maybe home defense, I don't think you have to have it. I don't think you definitely don't need it for competition. But for duty, the reason I say I think you need a forward assist on a duty rifle is because if you're doing a press check, so meaning you insert the magazine, you run the bolt, okay? Then what you do is you pull the charging handle back slightly just to check to confirm you have a round loaded in the chamber, release the actual handle. And what's gonna happen is a lot of times, I've personally seen it, I've personally experienced it, it doesn't seat the bolt completely enough that when you pull the trigger, it engages and actually strikes that firing pin. So you then hit the forward assist and the rifle's ready to go. Okay, now granted, if you pull the trigger and that happens, you're gonna have to run the whole thing. But that forward assist, what happens is after you do that press check, let the bolt go back forward, smack the forward assist, and the rifle's ready to go. On safe, close your dust cover, and the thing's car ready, duty ready, whatever it might be, whatever setting you leave the rifle in, it's ready to go. So I think you need that on a duty rifle. Not a big deal on this rifle. It's, for me, it's not a duty rifle. It looks too nice, frankly. But back here on the back end, buffer tube, six position buffer tube, Magpul SL stock on here, and then a castle nut. And the only thing I noticed about the castle nut is it is not staked on this rifle. Deal breaker? No, because I think if you really care about it that much, just stake it yourself. It's really easy. You can use a pin punch set and smack it with a hammer and you could stake it. Again, it's not done on this. I wish it was, but it's not. Now the rest of the rifle itself, you know, dust cover and the handguard up here. The handguard on this is going to be a full length handguard for the 16 inch barrel, so it's 15 inches. It is a wedge lock design with a key system that they use down here that they've designed, which has really good lockup. It's very stiff, and this is a very rigid handguard on here. And ultimately, this rifle as it sits is a 6 pound rifle, so it's not overweight. It's a good overall weight, and it seems really well made. Two finer points up here on the front of the rifle too I want to cover is that their barrels have a taper on them. So with that taper, if you don't have the actual, let's say, muzzle device like the cherry bomb that they have on here, threading a suppressor on there, what that does is it allows your suppressor to be on there perfectly concentric. And then on the handguard, you have mlok slots all the way around. There is no dead space on this thing whatsoever. I definitely prefer that handguard design with all the mlok on there, because sometimes, especially with that night vision class like we did, you get to mounting a laser aiming module on here, and then you put a light on here, and then you got a sling stud swivel or whatever it might be, you start running out of space. So having mlok all the way around is great to see. We're gonna go out on the range and we'll shoot it a bunch, but Andrew had the opportunity to shoot this thing a bunch already through a night vision class and me training him up to go to the class, and has well over 1,000 rounds to it, and it's been nothing but 100% reliable. Out of the box, I took it, lubed it up for him, had it ready to go. Running it through the class, we saw people with rifles that had issues. Andrew didn't have any issues with this rifle. A lot of folks had issues with their bolts locking up, magazines not seating. I mean, you name an issue with an AR, double feeds, whatever it is, it happened. No issues whatsoever with this rifle. And that's also coming from a user, and Andrew, that he's not the most experienced, but he knew how to run his rifle, and this thing didn't let him down one bit. And in regards to using this at a night vision class and shooting the crap out of this thing, there was actually somebody at the class, they joked and they said, is that a Q? And you have it out at a class? I thought those are just safe queens, which, I mean, look at Instagram and look at most of the people on YouTube, and they are safe queens for them. They don't shoot them because they look fantastic. But I think that they make a great rifle. So I think you should get out and shoot them and use these things like a tool that they're built for. So throwing the whistle tip on there, you know, like I said, that's like a blast deflector. The rifle is fantastic. But let's go out on the range. We'll talk about it a little bit more. I'll cover a few of the other features on the rifle, and we'll see how this thing shoots. We'll get these first shots at a Q Sugar Weasel. We'll start it off with a build drill. Yeah, I mean, literally the best trigger ever. That is quite frankly what it's called, and it, oh, sweet Jesus. Mmm, she's nice. Yeah, the Q Sugar Weasel, I mean, this sucker shoots flat. It really is. It comes back on target really easily. Overall, lightweight. It's a very comfortable rifle to shoot. Soft recoil impulse. And on this is they have their MF and cherry bomb normally. And then it just comes with threads that are actually exposed. So we actually went out and got the whistle tip for it, which they say it's for the pores. Because it's basically covering those threads, which are for their suppressors. So we got this just to cover it since we don't have a suppressor on at the time. And it works out really well. You can tell that it definitely deflects that blast out ahead of us. And that cherry bomb, we know, because Andrew shot it a lot during a night vision class, very effective. But overall, the rifle itself, just recoil wise, it feels good. It really does. And then on here too, you're gonna see that it has the Radian safety. This is gonna be a 70 degree throw on here with the 70 degree throw. These are also shorter levers than what you would normally get from a Radian safety selector switch, but overall good. And then in addition to that, the charging handle on here being the Radian, these are also a little bit shorter than what's normal. However, they're plenty large enough, even if you're wearing gloved hands or anything like that. What I noticed is that during a reload is that the paddle itself here for your bolt release is actually very similar to Geissele's Maritime Catch. So if you're familiar with that, this is nearly identical to that. I want to walk you guys through how the trigger is on this Sugar Weasel. They dub it as literally the best trigger ever. That's the name of it, and it's really darn good. If you're familiar with Geissele's G2S and the two-stage triggers from Geissele, it is better than those. So you have a little bit of take-up right there, and then a very clear and defined wall. No creep. Reset. That's it. Reset is like an eighth of an inch. If you're looking for a precision DMR trigger for a AR, I probably couldn't recommend this one. This trigger itself is fantastic for that. Outside of the trigger, being frankly the literally best trigger ever, it's just the reset and all that stuff on there is just so damn good. It is very, very easy to shoot. You can shoot it fast. I would highly recommend one for a DMR style rifle or for precision work. It's definitely there for that. You know, you see obviously we have an EOTech on here set up for this. We're gonna end up putting probably 1-10 on here in the future. But then outside of that, the controls and everything like that feel great. The lower itself is pretty, you know, generalized. It's not any different than most of them. You see it has the clear anodized on there. It looks good. It's a really cool looking rifle. And, you know, Andrew and I, we were talking about this rifle in general and the Q products, and that a lot of people, they buy them to be Instagram models. And this rifle, I mean, at this point, it has over 1,000 rounds through it between a class and shooting it and all that stuff. I lubed it up really well. I have not cleaned it yet. For myself personally, I clean my rifles pretty much every time I shoot them. However, if I'm trying to maybe evaluate, let's say, reliability of a brand new rifle, I won't clean it for maybe 1,000 rounds, maybe 2,000 rounds. And that's what we've done with this so far. And it's been 100% reliable for over 100 rounds with an adjustable gas block. It seems like it's weighted well. And then on top of that, you see we obviously have that blast factor. It shoots really well. And for, again, a rifle in a company, a lot of times you see their guns, you know, touted and you see them in pictures and all this stuff and people just not really running them hard. This thing would be a hell of a 3-gun rifle. So what I'm gonna work on now is some transition drills. You'll see we actually have some KCI USA AR mags. They sent these out to us just with no expectations. I have zero experience with the KCI stuff in the past, so I figured, you know, what the heck, I'm gonna give them a shot. So we're gonna run them here. This is gonna run me into a bolt lock, transition to my pistol, you know, fire a couple rounds and transition back into the rifle with a reload. We obviously covered all the furniture that's on the rifle. Probably one of the things that I disliked most personally for myself is I really don't like the Reptillia grip here. It's frankly too short for me and it's too small for my hand. I just don't like it. It feels too cramped. I definitely prefer the B5 stuff, the BCM gunfighter grip for sure. As far as the stock goes, the Magpul SL isn't my favorite. However, there's nothing wrong with that. I don't dislike it. I have one of these on a duty rifle and it works fine. But again, I just don't really care much for the Reptillia grip. If there's one thing like this rifle that I would have to change immediately, if this was my rifle and it's not, it's Andrew's, I would change the grip. I mean, it'd be gone probably in a day from shooting it. However, it's not bad and a lot of people may like it. It's just, for me, that Reptillia grip on here isn't it. The rifle though, I mean, there's nothing I can say bad about it, frankly. It shoots great, it shoots flat, it shoots fast. It's easy to shoot fast. The trigger is absolutely phenomenal. All the controls work flawlessly. The mag release is good. The bolt catch release is good. The safety selectors, everything on this rifle is just really well done. I'll just say is that for a rifle in this price range. These come in retail wise, you're looking street price at sub 1500. It'd be very hard to beat and find a better off the shelf rifle in that price range. I just think it's really well done. And I think in addition to that, as much as these things get touted as like an Instagram model and people just look at them, they look pretty, and they do, they look great. I think it's a really good rifle. I think it's really well done. I think it's well made, and I'm a big fan of them. And I would definitely recommend this for somebody, whether it's a new shooter, a beginner, a seasoned vet. I mean, really anybody. I mean, I don't know about duty use because the way it looks, but completely blacked out, it could definitely fit the bill. So if you like this video, you like the Q Sugar Weasel, drop us a like, comment, subscribe, and tell us your thoughts.